Good day and welcome back to another DBZ Dokkan Metal video. In this video we're going to be taking a look at the latest campaign to come to DBZ Dokkan Metal, and that is the Topper campaign. So we are going to be taking a look at basically just how much content we've got. Obviously we've got quite a bit going on right now with the global situation, because they're trying to cram as much content as possible. We got DFE Goku last week, we're getting DFE Topper this week, probably going to get AGL Jiren LR next week. They're just trying to cram as much as possible into this time period so that we can be caught up to JP. And I think this is fine. To a certain extent, they're trying their best, and I appreciate that. It is just making things very overwhelming for a lot of players, especially if you join during the anniversary. You're probably thinking, oh my god, this game just creates so much content. It's not always like this, although I'm not complaining too much, because hey, it's given us lots to do. In terms of login, it's a short campaign, only 15 days, only 15 stones. And in terms of missions, there's nothing too crazy. The missions do indicate part 1, which likely means we'll have a part 2. So just keep that in mind, which will probably be the release of Jiren, and will probably come towards the middle of next week. In terms of content for this campaign, we have inevitable showdown missions. We also have a new support boost memory, which has occurred. We have an SBR and ESBR stage. We have a new 1 week long Ultimate Clash, and we also have basically a ton of banners that have come as well. This Friday we'll also have a world tournament, and we'll be catching up on that as well. We also have a bunch of sub easy A's that are on the way, and for a limited time you'll be able to upgrade your character's hit pro system with just one dragon stone, which is pretty damn cool if you ask me. So all in all, some pretty interesting bits of content. Obviously, it doesn't seem like much on its own, but with the inevitable showdown missions, with the virtual Dokkan Ultimate Clash, and with all of the content that came with DFE LR UI Goku, there's plenty that is currently up right now for players to do. You also will have the sub-EZAs, you have an opening of a bunch of story events, and of course we still have the Breaking Siege event, and we have ESBR, SBR stages. There's a lot that's going on, so try your best to keep on track and on top of everything that's going on. Of course, we will do our best to tackle every single stage and to cover everything in the easiest way possible, but it is very difficult to always keep on top of everything. So if you're looking to do something that I haven't done yet or don't have a video on, and you need help, try and drop a comment, and I'll give you a reply at least to help you out. But ESBR, SBR, Support Memory Boost, Virtual Dokkan Ultimate Clash, and a bunch more sub-EZAs on the way, alongside the World Tournament on Friday, will keep you jam-packed right up until next week, with pretty much one or two things to do every single day, if you include also the previous content as well. So there is plenty to do, and don't panic about that. Of course, there should be more coming next week. I have a hunch we'll get AGL LR Jiren, who I think is the one big unit that we're missing. I think there are a couple more, but I think that's definitely the biggest one. And obviously, there's concerns about the Pepe Gal celebration that's currently out on JP, but we'll see where they fit all of that in. So at this point in time, there's plenty to do. Obviously, there is the banner up. However, I really think this is probably the first banner you can look at skipping. As with WWC, a potential joint, well, a joint 10th anniversary in whatever format that is, there's too much to summon for.